On a good weekend, up to 10,000 fans will hot-foot it to one of New Zealand's most exciting but least known sports, drag racing. At the drag strips, the action is short and furious. An average race is over in around 7 seconds in a burst of heat and flame. What sort of men turn themselves into human cannonballs? Ted Sheehan reports.
The aim of drag racing is simple: to cover one quarter of a mile in the shortest time.
A drag racer is a human cannonball without very much control over his final destination. To take part in the sport requires seemingly limitless amounts of time and a lot of money. It also helps to be completely crazy.
The way I look at this sport, it's like a drug, you know? And once you try it, you either get hooked or you say, no more, thank you, and you walk away from it. You try it and you get hooked. Boy, it's hard to get unhooked.
That feeling is unreal because you do know when you've gone so fast. When I've gone that fast, around 200 miles an hour, you know you've done it because you couldn't see when you went across the finish line. The windscreen is vibrating so much, it's just a massive blur.
I got a 69 Chevy with a 396, fuely heads and a Hurst on the floor.
Tidying, up.
She's waiting tonight down in the parking lot outside the 7-Eleven store. Me and my partner, Sonny, builds her straight out of scratch. And he rides with me from town to town.
It's close to midnight on Friday in the Hastings Garage Workshop of Brett Wilson, drag racer extraordinaire. He and his largely amateur crew are preparing for tomorrow's big meeting at Thunder Park. Their aim, a six-second orgasm of speed.
It's always a challenge to go faster and faster and faster.
What's the fastest you've ever gone?
Just under 200 miles an hour in 6.9 seconds.
Is it a challenge or is it simply that you're, well, slightly mad if you might...
Well, I guess. Yeah, whatever, I guess, yeah.
But you're a 37-year-old married man with two children.
Yeah, I guess.
So, you ever think of them as you're going 6 seconds down the track?
I haven't got time, but I think of them other times here.
It'll come as no surprise to the owner of the 1.3-litre family saloon to know that the technical drag racing description of this is a funny car.
Now some guys, they just give up living and start dying little by little, piece by piece. Some guys come home from work and wash up, then go racing on the street.
You've got to really drive one of these to get the thrill. The thrill is unreal. The vibrations of the car, and hey, whether the motor's going to actually last to the end of the quarter mile, because we are extracting every maximum piece of horsepower from this engine.
All sorts of people from all over the country have gathered here at Thunder Park. Some are here just to flash their chrome, others for the serious business of racing. They share a love of cars, speed, and the sort of technical jargon that Brett Wilson used to describe his engine.
This here is a 494 cubic inch Keep Black aluminium motor. It goes through an 871 supercharged with 43% overdriven. It is also port injected again by the fuel pump, which is running 20% overdrive. We're running the 90% nitromethane fuel, and that's what gives us our 2,000 plus horsepower.
That's incomprehensible to most people. In plain language, Brett's saying his funny car is 20 times more powerful than the ordinary car on the road. If you want an example of how the sport of drag racing can really obsess people, then here's the story of Mike Gearing. 3 years ago, he came down this track at almost 200 miles an hour. When he got to the finish line, his chute failed to open. The car went end over end 14 times and was completely demolished. Gearing broke his back and spent the next 2 months in hospital. And yet the next season, he was back on the track racing. Mike Gearing was working on his car in his South Auckland garage until 2 in the morning. Just 3 hours sleep, then he was on the road towing his 30-foot mobile workshop down to Thunder Park. Mike drives what drag racers call a rail, which simply means it's long and low. Mike's rail and Brett Wilson's funny car are two of fewer than 10 supercharged cars in this country which run on an explosive mixture of nitromethane and methanol. Among drag racers in New Zealand, they're the elite.
Why do you or anyone else become a drag racer?
Well, essentially to beat the other guy in the other lane. You know, it's you want to go quick and you want to beat the other guy. Simple as that. The speed is not the thrill, it's the acceleration. You know, a lot of people don't appreciate the difference between speed and acceleration.
What is the difference?
Well, a speed is sitting in an aeroplane at 600 miles an hour, 30,000 feet above the Tasman. Sipping your wine or eating your lunch or what have you, and everything's going along at 600 miles an hour with you, and everybody's comfortable. But speed, acceleration, is going from a standing start to 200 miles an hour in 1,320 feet. Yeah?
See, normal people would say you guys are crazy.
Well, I mean, you look at the name of my car there, I don't know whether you spotted it, Insanity 2. That's fair enough.
Names like Apocalypse, Rampage, and Devil Woman all help to demonstrate that for some, show means just as much as go. To the crowd, the pre-race burnout is a big part of drag racing's charm. To the driver, the revving and smoke mean heated tyres, which give him greater traction for the quarter-mile blast. Getting started in drag racing's the glamour part. Stopping's just as vital. An essential member of Brett Wilson's support team is his wife, Janice. She likes speed, but thinks all drag racers, including her husband, are crazy. Every race, she packs the parachute. Brett's safety is her responsibility.
I go with him everywhere he goes, because I like to see and make sure that he's going to go straight, or if he goes crooked, we're all there at the same time. I'd hate anybody to phone me and say he's had an accident, he's in hospital.
We haven't really got a lot of control. It's basically aim down the end of the drag strip and go, and that's it. And we just got to hope we get there all in one piece.
On a bad run where you've got to do some good driving, you know, if you do get into trouble, you can get into trouble. Like there was a guy at the last meeting, a champion, got into trouble and wiped the car out total.
It's a lethal-looking machine packed with an explosive fuel. Yet only one drag racer has been killed in New Zealand, and he was on a motorcycle. Mike's rail hasn't the brute power of Brett's funny car, but when it comes down to the line, both men know the race is often won or lost on the nerve of the driver.
We were talking to Brett last night, yeah. Brett Wilson, and he was telling us that you have to have real guts to run a funny car, and that guys who run rails are really just Sunday drivers. What do you reckon?
Well, there was some truth in that. The funny cars are definitely harder to drive, but these are quicker.
You reckon you're going to beat them?
That's what we're here for.
Brett, you've got the nickname of Vroom Vroom Wilson. Where on earth did that come from?
Well, I guess that originated in the early days when we were racing this car, trying to get enough nerve to steer the darn thing down the track, and I had to keep taking my foot off, then on again. It was going vroom, and off again, and vroom again, and we're all over the road.
Does that mean you actually lack the guts to put your foot down all the way?
Well, in those early days, when you try to convince yourself, hey, I've got to do it to get to that other end, I guess I did lack the guts to do it, but we soon got it.
Neither the preparations nor the psyching up helped Mike Gearing. He was left back on the line, his car crippled by an oil leak. These top cars can be as temperamental as any thoroughbred racer. Mike Gearing's problems at Thunder Park were caused by a $3 gasket, while rain washed out Brett Wilson's hopes. The two men agreed to race a week later here at Mary Mary's Champion Raceway. It's an expensive sort of challenge. These cars burn money. Nitromethane costs $2,000 a 44-gallon drum, which works out at $300 for a 7-second run. The cars cost a minimum of $20,000. The giant tyres, called slicks, $1,000 a piece, and they're good for only three seasons. At those figures, this is not a sport for penniless amateurs.
Mike, it could be a false impression, but you seem to be moving a little bit fast at the moment. This is a case of pre-race nerves?
No, we've got a lot to do, but you get nerves. You know, you'd be... You shouldn't be in the seat if you don't get nervous before a race.
Well, you've got to try and relax your mind and your body, and because there is a lot of pressure once you're on that start line, and you've got to have it all together.
You're up against Mike Gearing fairly shortly.
Yeah, right.
Are you really going to nail him today?
I hope to.
Did a phone the other day. I see Brett Wilson's going to have a crack at the national record today.
The engine is the bomb. It's like a grenade, you know. It can go off at any second, particularly when you're running nitro. They're fairly fragile things, these motors. They're made of cast iron and steel and so forth, but the fuel just goes like that and they're dead, you know.
Both cars will start us in place. Getting ready to fire up.
When the boys fire the motor up and the body comes down on the car, you're just completely divorced from the rest of the world. You come up, you stage at the lights, and hell, all you can see is the white centre line and the end of the track, and that's it.
Brett Wilson's car, the third of New Zealand. Gearing, wanting to go back. Looks like the car won't shift. Clutch is supposed to be locked up. Single run here. A bye run to Brett Wilson. Mike Gearing have put him on the start line, and out he goes. Greg revs off the start line. Well, lots of revs off the start line there, Phil, but obviously something's supposed to be going in the driveline department. The car just seemed to shudder.
Brett's luck lasted just 1 second longer than Mike's. Both cars went nowhere. Brett was so keen to beat Mike and the New Zealand record that he'd upped his fuel mixture. He was running on almost pure nitro. The result was disastrous.
Well, it's obvious we're making too much horsepower for what the poor diff could handle here today. This is the pinion, and it's got a bad case of toothache, but it proves a point that we were making over 2,000 horsepower out of the motor.
Will you race again today?
Unfortunately, no. I had to lend my spare diff to one of my fellow racers, and I don't feel it's a little ethical to take it off him today.
Are you disappointed? You've come a long way for this.
Yeah, but this is racing.
Mike, what happened on the start line then?
Well, we'd made some changes to the clutch to try and stop it from carrying the front wheels when we leave the start line. The changes we made were not right. The clutch locked up. We're going to change it and go out again and give it another go.
This car, the fastest in New Zealand, had Brett Wilson's spare diff. The driver, John Heskett, was more than eager to face up to Mike Gearing.
You on the line?
Driver. The nut behind the wheel was loose, if you like. I didn't have my brain in gear. That's what I was talking to you earlier. You've got to have your total concentration on that start line. I was off by half a tenth or a tenth.
Even so, both cars broke the 7-second barrier, a rare event in New Zealand drag racing. An hour and a half later, Mike was out looking for revenge. Oh,
a 7.149. John Hipkin. So Mike Gearing pulled out all the stops and runs a 6.788.
Well, Mike, you've just done the 6.78. What's it feel like?
Oh, that's terrific. You know, that's what it's all about. I also beat the other guy, you see. I left him at the start line. That's good. That restores my faith in myself.
When are you going to give it up?
If I get beat consistently on the line, I'll quit. Or I'll quit when I either get too scared or too broke.
Well, Brett, you've come a long way for not very much today. When are you going to give it up?
Oh, swim me blood. Can't give it up. This is racing. 'Cause baby,